I don't eat much. I don't know why. Only once in a day, but the Lord said, I am preparing you already. I don't feel hungry. I feel like really full of food inside of me. I know like 10 years ago, I've been through that kind of process. Not knowing now, again after 10 years, God is doing the same thing. So don't take it lightly, because God already giving us an open heaven.
Yes.
God, He will choose somebody which is nobody in the sight of any man, any natural man, simple woman, simple mother, simple any child. He can use it for His glory.
Amen.
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 So I'm in that situation. So today I pray almost 3 days. I say, Lord, what I'm going to deliver to your people. I just, between two things, and the Holy Spirit confirmed me with the vision which I'm going to really deliver. It says the topic will be, I'll give it to you now, because it's very divine. The topic that I got, divine power of God for divine purpose. The divine power of God for divine purpose. That's the topic which I am going to speak. As long as the Holy Spirit allow me, it could be half an hour, could be 20, just move in spirit. I am not a good preacher. I am just delivering the message, all right? Amen. So, this is the Holy Spirit we are getting in. We are going to, talk about the Holy Spirit. So, since the topics that you know that I already told you, divine power of God for divine purpose. Deeply speaking about the Holy Spirit now. All right? Okay. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. The Bible says in the book of Matthew, what is the Holy Spirit? When God touched His people, always will take today, which I'm going to touch three things. When God touched His people, three things will happen. Okay? Which is, will give a guidance. He will give a vision, and He will give you a vision, and He will give you a power. Amen. First, He's going to guide you and lead you by His Spirit. Because we are the children of God, we are already have the Spirit of living God.
Amen.
From the beginning, when God saved us, that, you remember when Jesus said for Nicodemus, how come I would be, you know, man get born again unless... Yeah, I'm already born, but unless going to His mother's womb. But you see that flesh, born by flesh, but the Spirit of God in us, born the Spirit.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
So we are a spirit being, having it, living in the body, and we have a soul. Yes. So, which Jesus was already talking about, the Holy Spirit, born again Christian. We are believers. Yes. This is us, which is us. Born again Christian, filled, empowered by God Almighty.
Amen.
When the power of God comes upon each individual people, what is going to happen? That's going to be my highlight. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. So, a few scriptures we're going to read. First, we're going to read from John 16, 13. John. Hallelujah. And I'm trying to take slowly, slowly, and just follow me. Hallelujah. God is awesome.
Yeah.
When God speaks, we hear, okay?
Amen.
Doesn't matter. Every time when God speaks, something will happen. It's not God just speaking, He's doing. Glory to God.
Amen.
It says in the John 16, John 16, verse 13, I will read. Howbeit, when He, the Spirit of truth, is come, He will guide you into all truth. For He shall not speak of Himself, but whatever He shall hear, that shall He speak. And He will show you things to come. Amen?
Amen.
So, as I said, when God, when the Spirit of God comes upon the people, He will guide. When we say guide, will show you something. It will be a vision. It will give you a purpose. So you capture that. As a people of God, as a children of God, since God putting out His Spirit, we have to be really diligent. We have to be also careful what He tried to explain to us. Amen?
Amen.
Are you with me? Please, don't move around. You are distracting me, okay?
Amen.
We have to be careful. We are before the Lord and before the Holy Spirit. God is not interested in how we ask, we moving around. We have to be sensitive because God is the Spirit is very sensitive. Amen?
Amen?
So when God is really speaking to us, giving us guidance, always He put His Spirit in us in order to guide us, to give us purpose.
Amen.
Some of us, we may get vision. Some of us, He may speak, do this. So the first thing when God is encounter with mankind, when He put His Spirit in mankind, and to His Spirit, He gives guidance.
Amen.
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 So God, when He gives you guidance, there is no confusion.
Amen.
You know what to do.
Yes.
Because you have been praying.
Yes.
So God is intervening. When He's intervening, you have His guidance, you have His purpose, you have your vision. So you focus. Amen?
Amen.
You focus. So, praise the Lord. Amen. That's the first thing when God encounters with His children, with His people. He gave us vision. That's what's happening to me.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
I am a living testimony.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
So today, I have come to tell to New Awakening, people of God, do you have a purpose from God?
Mm.
Do you have a vision from God?
Mm.
Did you capture His will and purpose in your life?
Hallelujah.
Are you aligning with His will and purpose, people of God?
Yes.
Because when God touches you, you're not going to be the same.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Nobody's going to be the same after being touched by God Almighty.
Amen. Yes.
My life never been the same. My walk never be the same. My thinking never be the same. My walk never be the same. My talk never be the same.
Amen.
So today the Holy Spirit is speaking to us, to me, also to you.
Amen.
I'm not bringing this message only for you, people, precious people of God.
Yes.
It is also God is dealing with me.
Amen.
In the process. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God. So we have a guidance. It's not coming the Holy Spirit just to make us warm and ha ha ha, worship here, worship there. Or some of us going from place to place. When you have a purpose, you stand firm. Hallelujah.
Oh yes.
Praise the Lord. When God speaks, you know. You know your God. No matter what it takes, you stand firm and focus. Glory to God. So, when God gives His precious Spirit, when you have a divine, getting divine power, that's for divine purpose. Amen?
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Are you with me?
Yes.
Give the glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, this is the first thing that I want you to see. And then, you see that? Purpose. Sometimes, for example, the Lord, when He spoke to Pastor Immaculate and her husband, when He gave a vision, He told her the place, the location. You see, the purpose of God without location, without guidance, is nothing. God will give you the place. For some people, it might be locations. Could be people who will give you some address or will give you some country. You see, we're all different. So God has also different assignment for each individual. So to get it right, to get the will and the purpose of God for your life, you must be aligned with the precious is how to do it. You see? When God gives a vision, He gives you also strategy how to do it. You remember when Moses met at the burning bush?
Yes.
When he revealed God, he just simply, his father-in-law sheep, he went in the field to let them feed, and then he saw the burning bush.
Yeah.
You see how God is communicating with His glory, with His power, with His spirit differently with different people.
Yeah.
So he went to see.
Yeah.
So out of that bush, the voice spoke to him. Take off your shoe, and this is the holy ground.
Yeah.
And he gave him where to go, the place.
Mm-hmm.
He guided him. He gave him a vision, the purpose. Even though in God's agenda for Moses, I believe, that was the day that he got the revelation.
Mm-hmm.
He never knew when his mom was throwing him away in the river. He never knew that when he was fed by his mom in the house of Pharaoh. He never knew when his people for 100 years, Israel has been buying bondage. He never knew it. But he has that manhood. Inner him, already the purpose of God being planted. Remember in the book of Jeremiah, before the foundation, before you are in your mouth, mother's womb, I knew you.
Yes.
So God knew.
Yes.
That was a divine connection, right in the field.
Yes.
Today, for me and for you, where is our connection?
Yes.
Do we have our prayer place? Are we praying? Do we have really separate from a lot of stuff? God is speaking. Because He needs us, He needs you, He needs me. He needs man, He needs woman. He don't need any talker. He don't need any criticizer. We have to be aligned with the divine purpose of God Almighty. So, God gives His strategy, the way to go and to approach Pharaoh. The way to go, how to talk, the way to do things until the end of his life. Amen?
Amen.
That's why when we capture, when we are really getting the vision and the will of God in our life, we have to be faithful until the end. Hallelujah.
Amen.
No matter what happened in the way, no matter the ups and downs, no matter the loneliness night, no matter the tears that we have shed, God Almighty with His sovereign wisdom, He knows how He will take you out of that things.
Amen.
He will send His power, His spirit,
amen,
to break every yoke, every curse, every bondage, every infirmity. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You don't need to be fearful.
Amen.
We serve the Most High God. The power of God is still unveiled, is still waiting for His children. People of God, how can I tell you? God is real.
Amen.
Amen.
God is real, brothers and sisters.
Amen.
We have to be careful, because it's not going to be business as usual 2018, because God already spoke about it. What have you done? What have you been commitment? What is your commitment in 2018? What is the commitment I need for God, what I'm going to do for His kingdom? Every day I have to die, that's how I know. I'm not dying yet, trust me.
Amen.
I'm not dying yet, every day I try. Because we are all in process.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
When we're hard, we all in process.
Amen. Yeah, amen.
That process never ended. Every day we have to walk in holiness.
Yes.
Every day we need the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Apply upon from the top of our head to the bottom of our feet.
Amen.
Every day we need each other.
Yes.
Every day we have to encourage ourselves.
Amen.
Our brothers, sisters in Christ.
Yes.
Every day when I see something, I have to go and forgive somebody.
Yes.
For some of us, I'm an evangelist, for example, when they ordain me, because that's what God is putting me. But it doesn't mean I don't have any giftings, because sooner or later I don't have any title. I don't need any title anyways.
That's right.
They have to ordain me somewhere.
That's
when
right.
They ordain my sister, what's her name?
Pastor Sil.
Cecilia, pastor. They have to ordain her because God wants her to be a pastor.
Amen.
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 So when they ordain me, me and Dr. Thomas, we sat because he's my spiritual father. She said, Esther, what do you think? What do you want us to say? So what's the Holy Spirit putting? I said, I'm an evangelist. I can't be silent from telling people Jesus loves you, Jesus saves you. That's me.
Amen.
You see?
Amen.
You have to know your giftings, people of God.
Amen.
When God is bringing you, He knows what He's doing in your life.
Amen.
So we have to be faithful. So the Spirit of God, again, He went to Ezekiel. You see how He approached the angel? He told him, do you think these bones are they going to live? He said, I don't know. Speak, prophesy. You have to know your assignment. When you are communicating with God by His Spirit, when you have a divine attachment, divine purpose of God in your life, you have to know what's that purpose, what's that really main assignment for your life.
Amen.
If God said, go and speak, you speak.
Amen.
If God, He said, face Pharaoh, you go and face Pharaoh.
Amen.
No compromise.
That's right.
Amen?
Amen.
When God said, go and touch somebody, lay hands upon and recover and be healed, you do that.
Amen.
When God said, prophesy, you prophesy on the dry thing, that shall live.
Amen.
Because He is God.
Yeah.
When He said, do it, you're going to do it.
Amen.
Because He is God Almighty, He can't limit. We can't limit Him. That's why when God said do, I am really quick to do it. Amen?
Amen.
I will say that there is time also for everything. We have to know that the timing of God too, alright?
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So this is the work of the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
You see? God is in the business of looking people to put out His Spirit. We always pray, God Almighty, please help me, please help me. We have to do this, I have to do this, I have to do that. But you have to know the purpose why you are asking the anointing.
Hmm.
Because the anointing is not coming for just nothing.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He is Jehovah,
wow.
Jireh, Jehovah Nissi. He knows what He's doing in the midst of His people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number three, I'm going to the number three, the power of God. He's going to give you power, number three. Number one, I say vision and then strategy. Are you following me?
Amen.
God knows you. Let me see your hands. Are you with me?
Amen.
I don't want to lose you. Glory to God.
Amen.
I'm going to move in the number three, power. God, when you have a divine purpose from God, when you have a divine encounter with God, when He gives you His Spirit, His ability, His strength, when you are meeting Him, the third level is going to be, He's going to be anointing you. You got the vision, you got the strategy, how to do it. The vision, you know where you're going. Okay? And then, you are going to be empowered. You remember in the book of Acts, when Jesus told them to stay in unity, in one accord, in upper room. What did they do? They were with Jesus before He is ascending, right? They were following Him. They have seen a lot of things, what He's doing. They have seen it all. Some of them even, sometimes they deny Him. The fear grasped them. Finally, they were waiting that upon that the powerful visitation of the Holy Spirit. So God Himself, He released the power which is without the power of God. No matter you have a vision, you have this, you have that. Unless with fasting and praying, there is no power.
Amen.
Trust me, people of God. If that's not the case, I wouldn't be praying, fasting 10 years. 2008, we launched Prophetic Liberty Universal Ministry. But it was a preparation, going to school, at the same time working full time, coming to school, fasting, praying, traveling, traveling. Sometimes I will go place to place, street from street, corner to corner, to pray, to cry. When I came in the night, I will have a visitation. God finally, when I see, when I know, when God reveals the power, the timing, that's the time I can't be silent.
Amen.
See, the power of God, when He empowers you, you can't be silent anymore.
That's true.
Is anybody want the power of God?
Yes.
You need a power to pray.
Yes.
You need a power even to sing, to worship God to the highest of your ability.
Yes.
You need a power of God even to counsel with the people.
Yes.
You need a power of God even to communicate, to have a good friendship.
Yes.
You need a power of God even to live with your precious husband, precious wife.
That's true. That's true.
To live in harmony.
Yes.
People of God, you may be today a single mother. You may be today divorced. But God Almighty, no matter what you're going through, He's still empowering you.
Amen.
He never leaves forsaking you.
Amen.
So that power came upon those disciples. Guess what? They can't be silent. Now the upper room is open. Hallelujah.
Amen.
By the gifts of the holy power of God Almighty. That's why Peter, he went and winced 3,000 people. The first church being established. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
When God giving you power, you can't be silent now.
Amen.
You ask power, you ask the Spirit of God, help me, let me go. Help me, release me, heal me, this and that. Today the Holy Spirit said, what you gonna do about it?
Mm.
We have to humble ourselves because we are serving the Most High God. We have to feel, we have to reverence by His precious,
hallelujah,
merciful, graceful, unconditional love. I'm standing today here.
Amen.
I'm nothing.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I make really nothing. Him be glorified throughout my life.
Hallelujah.
That's why I decided to follow, to serve Him.
Hallelujah.
I have seen His mercy.
Yeah.
I have seen His really mighty healing power. I can't even explain. That's why sometimes when we are here with your pastor, some Monday I will come. I say, Pastor, in the spirit, when we are praying, three of us with coffee. And then I say, this is what happened in the realm of the spirit. This is what when Jesus went in my bedroom, this is what happened. I was dead. She is shocked, and the glory of God will really covering us, and we discuss that heavenly thing. You can't tell even to the people today because they're underestimating the power of God.
Amen.
People of God don't underestimate the power of the Spirit.
That's
right. The anointing of God. God loves you.
Hallelujah.
You have to respect the grace.
Yeah.
Your sister, your brother beside you is precious, bought by the blood of Jesus Christ. We need to respect each other because God is real.
Yeah.
I have seen the hand of God. I'm a little woman. When He is really coming, I'm just, you know, two times I almost died anyways. Two times or three times I thought my mind's already lost. Like I'm praying. Because when you see Jesus, you're not gonna be the same.
Amen.
When you even walk in a spirit, you don't even know it. You see? We have to be in the spirit. We have to be empowered by God. So these disciples, they went and they really conquered a lot of souls. Until this very day, the gospel of the kingdom of God, unless we are going to be empowered, unless we are going to be sanctified, unless we are going to be set apart, we are not going to be part of it. Because you know what you know, who you are in Christ.
Amen.
Somebody to say negative thing upon any man and woman of God, he must be not knowing himself.
My God.
We have to. When God is really who you are in Christ, you are bold to say, Jesus saves.
Amen.
Jesus loves you.
Amen.
Jesus heals.
Yes.
Jesus sees. Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I'm an overcomer.
Amen.
There is no time to say negative thing.
Yes.
You may be sick. You may be afflicted. For Job also been sick, but he never really despised, questioned God.
No.
Until the end of that temptation to end by God saying, you are faithful. So be healed. He restored him in double portion.
Yes.
But we never heard about his wife because she'd been speaking negative things.
Yeah.
We have to be careful what even saying to ourselves.
Yes.
You are worthy.
Yes.
You are victorious.
Amen.
You should know what the Spirit of God is saying.
Yes.
Who you are. You have to know the realm of the Spirit, victorious.
Yes.
Overcomer.
Yes.
More than conqueror, healer.
Yes.
You healed. You've been healed.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That's the power we are looking for. That's the power God said, shall it be. That's the power God is going to be released.
Amen.
But without holiness, no man can see. That's a challenge today for me and for you.
Amen.
For me to come in my age. I'm not young, you know, because I'm anointed.
I like that.
To God. I don't lie to you. Be honest. I'm approaching. Late. Or beginning somewhere. To stand in holiness, walking in holiness, it costs you even your beauty.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Woman of God, so precious man of God, with your really respect, are we really as set aside for God? Are we living in holiness? This is a challenge for me, for you, really, sister. For you, for my precious sisters, people of God, the temple of Christ.
Amen.
This precious temple.
Amen.
In front of this woman of God, we went one time in. That doesn't mean there is no temptation, you know. I am a living testimony. If I tell you what I'm going through every once in a while here, I have to rebuke here, I have to rebuke here, I have to sit very hungry in the spirit.
Yes.
Because no one comes between in God.
Amen.
This anointing, this grace that God put it in me, upon me,
yes.
It's cost to me.
Yes. Yes.
What can I say? Better die.
Yes.
And go to heaven to be forever with my God.
Yes.
So holiness is the essence of the power of God that in order to come to us.
Amen.
I know it. And I ask talk to, you know. So we rebuke that. Until today, I just destroyed the car. You see, you have to know the agenda of the enemy.
Yes.
You have to know the assignment of the enemy because you are anointed.
Yes.
You have come in the kingdom of God for such a time as this.
Yes.
God is going to use you.
Amen.
As a mother to counsel the motherless. God wants you as a father to counsel the fatherless.
Amen.
God wants you to be a sister, the sisterless.
My God.
Who's gonna send God? Guess what? If we are despising him, rejecting him. People of God are putting what the Spirit of God putting it in my heart.
Amen.
Capture his purpose.
Amen.
Capture his agenda, kingly agenda, heavenly agenda,
yes,
which already he unveiled.
Yes.
I believe with all my heart. I know Pastor Immaculate and her team, ministerial team, invite a lot of people of God here.
Yes.
They pour out their spirit. They pour out the revelation, what God told them to do, including me. This is my second time.
Yes.
If you say, I am waiting upon God, God is urging you to be a witness to your neighbor, to bring a lost soul, because the anointing, the power of God requires work. Faith without work is nothing.
Yes.
We are empowered. We are the children of God, graceful, powerful. That precious blood of Jesus, when God gives you anointing you, so he protects you.
That's true.
How is the people of God? We are entering into the new beginning 2018. We have come through a lot of difficulties. 2018 is going to be a different. 2018 is going to be really mighty. So we have to focus into evangelization. We have to focus bringing people so they might know. We have to be prayerful. We need to pray intensely. Intensive prayer is required. Yes, your household is okay, but your neighbors are not okay. Your workplace might be okay. You, your family not be okay. Be wise. Be faithful. Be diligent. Be holy, for we serve the holy God.
Amen.
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 We give the glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Did you learn something?
Amen.
Give the glory. Jesus, he never made a mistake, people of God. God is awesome.
Amen.
So today I ask you, once again, we are all here before the holy, precious presence of God Almighty. 2017 already passed. We have come together with love and compassion. So many gifts. We celebrate Christmas. We cross a new year with joy. We're singing hallelujah. But some of us here, I know the Holy Spirit is speaking to me. You may not be forgetting to really to come to Christ fully, to commitment, into commitment, to surrender. The past is past. Lord, what you're speaking to me is today for me. I need this power. I need your spirit. I need to get there. I'm not gonna every Sunday coming without purpose. As a family, when God give it to you, that's a purpose. It's the nurturing of the family, the children. The responsibilities that God gave you is right with God. We have to ask our heart, people of God. Are we giving the time that's supposed to be the prayer time with the family? Are we taking a time alone with God, seeking his face? We know we capture his vision, we capture his purpose. We know already he's revealing us what to do, but still we are waiting to empower by him. but you can pray. Today is your day. I'm asking you once again to have a commitment. If you need a prayer, first of all, is anybody that he never received Jesus Christ as his Savior and Lord? Can I see your hand? All of us are believers.
Amen.
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 So if that's the case, I'm asking you. This is very serious. This is very serious. You need to be correct once again with the Lord. God is making available himself for us as a church, as a body of Christ. The last days, anointing, the latter rain already pouring out. People have seen a lot of heavenly things. Trust me. I'm a witness. We need to be that part of it. We need to see heavens open in our home. We need to always, we can't be like this. We need to carry that heavy anointing. The time has come. God is calling us. God is calling us to come closer to him because he is closer than the breeze that he takes. God is bringing a new people, a new man and woman who are anointed to stand with you.
Yes, Lord.
That's me and your pastor pray almost 3 months ago here in this place. God is bringing a new people. Anointed people. You have seen that. It's not a joke. God is aligning. We need to be really serious with God's business.
Amen.
If anybody is saying, I need a prayer, I make it this time, that's the end of it. May God help me. I need a prayer. I need help. I need help. I need a prayer. God to strengthen me. I want to make a commitment. Each week, at least one person, you can't even evangelize. I need that commitment. God wants that commitment, by the way. Because you may not know how to evangelize. Just make available yourself. Like I said to you, I witness. This is what God did. Just say Jesus loves you. Just show love, compassion to your neighbor, to your friends. Whatever in the streets, it's a good area, this area, to give them really a good compassionate, good communication because they need that.
Amen.
Some of them, you know, that this family sends them out,
yeah.
Kicks them out.
Yeah.
Some of them are a lot of crisis.
Yeah.
Some of them mentally sick, depressed, oppressed.
Yeah.
They need the, our love.
Amen.
I need you today to make a commitment. If you need a prayer, me and your pastor, we're going to pray. You have to come. I want to pray also for my sister here, which I love. I want to pray. And we need a prayer. You have to come. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I need a worship.